God bless and good evening once again. This is Brother Darren, Hebrews 9 verse 27 and John 3 verse 16. So I'm looking at this post that has just been posted on Sky News recently, this article. It's in regards to Billie Eilish. In my last video, I just covered Billie Eilish and the chart top 20, and I detailed the artists that were on there, occult or perverse connections, symbolism, and, you know, effectively how these young artists are used as pawns, or effectively the devil gives a window or an avenue, a platform for his perversion to be projected to the rest of the world. And as I said, I covered Billie Eilish already, but I just wanted to cover this Sky News article just to show the level of success that she's gained. So, yet again, I pray for Billie Eilish and all the youngsters that might listen to this. This exposes what is behind the music industry, what the executives are prepared to push that matches up with Satan's agenda. There's no other way to put it. But let's cover this quickly now. So No Time to Die, Billie Eilish makes history as James Bond theme tops charts. Grammys, Brits, record-breaking hits. Billie Eilish's success continues with James Bond's song No Time to Die hitting number one. So she's topped the charts with her James Bond theme track, breaking the modern day record for the highest 007 single opening week sales of all time. No Time to Die, the song for the film of the same name and the teenager's first UK number one single, has racked up 90,000 chart sales and 10.6 million streams in its first week of release. At 18, Eilish is the youngest artist and first woman to score a number one with their 007 theme tune. The official charts company says that opening week chart sales are understood to be the biggest for a Bond theme of all time based on its available records. In modern times, Adele's Skyfall managed 84,000 chart sales in its opening week in October 2012, while Sam Smith's The Writing on the Wall for follow-up Spectre achieved 70,000. So as we can see, she has quite literally top the charts. And as I've mentioned to you already, you know, Billie Eilish is being used to push an agenda of Satanism or satanic symbolism. We can clearly see it here once again on the album cover, When We All Fall Asleep, Where Do We Go? There we have her there sitting there as if she's demonically possessed, with opaque eyes. That is the chart top 20 with her riding high, so to speak, on top. And yet again, we have her hair with the infamous one eye symbol or picture and pose, which most of the top artists either do that symbol or the three sixes across the eye. It just seems to be something that the paymasters in the industry, those that are in the secret fraternities, seem to be able to induce out of their superstars, and it effectively just gets them to pay homage to their paymasters, who have all sorts of occult tie-ins, which ties in with the music as well. Just before I go, though, we're going to look at some scripture once again and how scripture coincides with all of this. And we're reading from Matthew chapter 4. And we're going to read from verse 8. And it says, again, the devil taketh him, that's Jesus, who was under temptation, up into an exceeding high mountain. And he showeth him all the kingdoms of the world and the glory of them. And he said unto them, all these things will I give thee, if thou wilt just fall down and worship me. Then Jesus said, get thee hence, Satan, for it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. Then the devil left him, and behold, angels came and ministered unto him. Now, how does this scripture connect to Billie Eilish? It simply is that, in a sense, either indirectly or directly, she's paying fealty or homage or worshipping the devil via the lyrics that are in her records or her songs, and also via what is on the actual albums, or the album cover, I should say. And she seems to have gained pretty much unrivaled success. She's not an exceptional talent, although she writes with her brother. And she seems to have been placed on a pedestal as far as the spiritual and supernatural forces of this world are concerned, to place her into that position of prominence and wealth. Because the devil will definitely reward those who are working towards him, taking as many as he can to hell in a lake of fire. We have to remember that when Jesus came out to cast out demons, the demons turned around and said, "Have you come for us before the time?" So all the devil can do is work to maximize the amount of souls that he can take to that fiery destruction with him. But the funny thing is, people will still see all this. They'll still see that it shows the truth and the proof and the evidence, or evidences that are linked to revealing supernatural forces and their intricate work here on this earth through mainstream popular artists and film actors, you know, those who we would envy for their success. And he's literally prepared to take them and any followers of them who don't repent and believe on the Lord Jesus to their doom. So, you know, I'm just going to end on this as we have it here, Matthew 4, verse 4. But he answered and said, "It's written, man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God." I'm going to end the video here. Once again, this is Brother Darren, Hebrews 9, verse 27, and John 3, verse 16. And I always encourage and implore people to seek the Lord while he may be found. Believe on the Lord, accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. Repent, be baptized, read your Bible, find a good church to go to, develop a personal relationship with the Lord, and you will be saved from the judgment that is to come, which is called the second death, which we find in Revelation, where if your name is not in the Lamb's Book of Life, you will be cast into the lake of fire. God bless, Brother Darren, Hebrews 9, verse 27, and John 3, verse 16.